Hello, it's Games, Brains, Headbanging Life here. Here with a track by track and in tribute to their final ever UK show this weekend at Download Festival 2019, we're covering Slayer, a Slayer album. Can you guess which one? Rain and Blood, because no one said anything. I was waiting for you to say something.
Oh, no, because it was like my brain freeze up.
No one's talking back to me, you know, This isn't an audience. So it's the final ever UK show taking place at Download. If you think you're going to see them again after this, no, because this final tour has been ongoing for 2+ years already. They played the UK last year. This is just a wrap up at a festival they've always played. So
I think it's final as well for them.
I believe so.
I think so. I don't think they're going to cash in. I don't know.
Never say never.
But they don't do anything separate from Slayer. I think Slayer's Slayer. Like, I don't...
We never thought in a million years you'd get a Guns N' Roses reunion. 10 years down the line, one-off shows at a festival, Slayer, one-off show, very possible. I would say never. The reason why I know what you're saying now, and it's credibility. And you automatically, like I do, put a lot more credibility on the likes of Slayer than you do other bands.
Yeah.
You don't think money when you think Slayer.
Yeah, I just think of like Dee Snider's like really kind of like shady, like when we say we're not doing anymore, that's with Sister, we're not doing anymore. And you believed him, he's like, we're not going to come out 10 years later, this is it. And I believed it with him and I believe it with Slayer. So.
Okay.
I might eat my words later on, but.
I would say never in regards to this. The possibility with enough money, 10 years down the line, an easy headline slot at Download or whatever might be worth it. But there you go. We're not here for that. We're here for the track by track. Now, This is going to be a short one because this is Rain and Blood. It's Slayer's most famous album.
Yep.
Not necessarily their best. I'm more of a Seasons in the Abyss kind of guy.
Definitely. I know that, like, back to front, inside out.
But this does have some of their biggest hitters and songs that are live staples. Mm. Live staples, basically. And that's one, the first one we open with is a live staple, which is Angel of Death. It's great. It's fantastic. It's one of their best songs.
Yeah.
It's one actually I don't get sick of hearing, you know. I'm not saying I get sick of hearing like the likes of other ones.
But it's just always like your go-to. Like,
banger. Absolute banger. Piece by Piece.
Short and sweet.
Yeah, I mean.
Go Back In. Well, that's like, all Slayer songs are pretty short and sweet. That's like their go-to and it's fresh. It's like, bosh, in you go.
Well, it's kind of funny because Angel of Death is the longest song on this album, but you get Piece by Piece, 2 minutes, 2 seconds. Necrophobic, 1 minute, 4 seconds. Altar of Sacrifice, 2 minutes 50. Mm. Jesus Saves, 2:54.
Yeah.
These are all quick, fast and short and sweet. Yeah. The first half of the album, Barn Angels of Death, it's just face-melting, wall-to-wall songs.
It's 80s Slayer, isn't it?
Of those four I've mentioned, which of those do you like the most? Stands out for you? Because
Piece by Piece.
Yeah. Oh, really? I was going to say Necrophobic.
No, Piece by Piece for
me. I love Necrophobic. It's almost punk style, how short and sharp it is in that sense.
Yeah.
It's... very, like, when you go, it's very traditional Slayer. This is what we're referring to.
I love a traditional Slayer.
That's what we're referring to. As if, like, this is only their third album. You know, it's not exactly like, oh my God, by this point, they were, you know, traditional Slayer. This is before there was traditional. It was 1986 release, you know. But this is what, nowadays, when we refer to traditional Slayer, this is what we're talking about. Longer songs would come later.
Yeah.
Back then, it was short and sharp and in your face. Then we get the excellent Criminally Insane. Again, there's nothing really to break down. It's always that fast, you know?
Yeah,
it's
just like, you know it. Going to be solid. Like when you see them live, it's always just like, it's always so strong. I've never seen like a bad. I've seen Slayer shows that could be better, but they're always so like solid. Yeah,
that's fair pot, right? Not bad, but I've seen Slayer shows where it's so.
Yeah, and I've like, I could have done a bit more from you, but other times I'm like, yeah.
And a lot of these tracks just don't get played because they've got a back catalogue of
so much.
Yeah. Why would you? You know, same Reborn, Epidemic, and Postmortem.
Yeah.
Of those ones, I'd probably lean towards Epidemic as being one that I'm more familiar with. I'm like, yeah, if that came on, I'd be like, okay, that's cool. That's all of them. You'd be like, oh, that's Slayer. It's not like, oh my God, I don't know who this band is.
Yeah.
But it's a really short album as well because of that. You kind of think of Rain of Blood, you think of this huge Slayer album, yeah, but it comes in at less than 30 fucking minutes. Yeah, yeah. And the only reason it's long is because of Angel of Death at the start and Raining Blood at the end, yeah, which are 4+ minute songs.
That's like a third of the track list.
Basically,
yeah. Songs, yeah.
But I think that's probably why it had a lot more impact as well. You know, because these were so short and constantly fast, there's no slowing down, except at the start of Raining Blood, you know? Which, obviously, everybody knows. It's fucking awesome. Iconic. It's going to go down in history as one of the most iconic tracks ever.
Yeah, from the opening. I like listening to it when it's raining, because again, I kind of like it's quite atmospheric. Listen to it when it's raining.
It's a song I've heard so many times, but I will admit that I still, when that dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, it's exciting. Yeah, I think I get things making that think back better now.
I'm picturing the last time I saw him, which was at Bloodstock, and the lights went out. It was dark. And the lights went out on the stage, and that I don't want the dun, 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 you get that red flash.
Yeah,
and the thunder cracking, it is awesome. Yeah. And then you get that first riff. You know, it's just like, yeah, it's. It's awesome. Yeah, it's one of those where it's like, yeah, even, yeah, get excited thinking about it. So, yeah, like, I imagine that's what they're going to sign off with at Download.
Yeah.
I would sign off with it.
The coolest thing, the coolest time I've seen them doing Raining Blood was, they did it in America.
Well, you didn't see it then, did you?
No, I watched it on a DVD. Right. I would love to have seen it live. But for Raining Blood, they actually had it raining blood. They finished that song, because obviously it knackered all their equipment, but they had, like, sprinklers set up, so the whole stage was covered in blood. And it looks so cool in it.
Yeah, that's incredible in that sense. Cool. Yeah, like definitely what you end with.
And I thought, I'm never going to see that. And I was like, American people. But yeah, the set must have been immense. But yeah, they finished with that because obviously it must have all got into like everywhere.
Yeah. You're not going to go on a Karen playing off of that, are you?
Yeah,
go wash it all off.
Yeah, go on YouTube, put in Raining Blood. Like, I think it's like New York Ballroom or somewhere in America. But they actually had real Raining Blood again.
Well, I will find it if I can, and I will add it now. So it seems like we're glossing over these songs. The reason being is because, ultimately, as great as this album is, when you've been listening to Slayer most of your life and you have so many albums, a lot of these tracks are forgettable. Given them a re-listen, what you're getting is what I would describe as hot and heavy thrash music.
Yeah.
Thrash metal, Slayer, playbook.
Tight. That's what it feels like. You're just like.
And they fly by. And I think because it's bookended by two such strong tracks, we're not just talking about two good tracks, two Slayer classics. That's what you always come back to. So you end up ignoring what are good songs. I don't think there's a bad song on this album.
No.
I think there's a couple that are forgettable.
Yeah.
Jesus Saves. For its controversy, more than anything else, that's why it stands out. Post-Mortem. Forgettable. Yeah. That's it. In the sense that in a Slayer best of, it's not in there.
No.
But when it comes in, you're like, oh, I haven't heard this in a long, long time.
Yeah.
Cool, let me continue to listen to it. More likely to listen to those nowadays than I am Angel of Death and Rain and Blood.
Just to break it up
more than anything else. But it did get a 1998 reissue with two bonus tracks, which is Aggressive Perfecta and a remix of Criminally Insane.
See, when I put remix on like metal songs, I still think of like dance tracks. Yeah. I'm like, of course it's not. Like, it just that word remix makes me think of remix.
Yeah, like it's gonna be like dum-dum-dum-dum-dum, you know, that kind of thing. Yeah.
Dance mix or something stupid. But yeah, solid album. I say, yeah, definitely check out Slayer if you get a chance. If you're at download, but younger, you might not have seen him before. Don't disregard and go say that you saw them and
so
enjoy
yeah,
it. Enjoy
seeing
it.
One of the most iconic bands.
Yeah.
And you will get tracks from this album. Mm. You will get two at least, Angel of Death and Raining Blood,
yeah,
for sure. Yeah. Unlikely to get a rest because I think it'll probably only be for like an hour or so.
Yeah, so we've got to fill it up.
But it is one of Thrash's greatest albums, and if you were doing like a top 10 Thrash albums, there's a strong case for this being number one.
Yeah.
Number one, if not top three, for sure.
Definitely.
For sure. Yeah. And there you go. There's a track by track for Raining Blood. Make sure you check out the rest of the track by tracks. If you want to recommend us to do something, drop it in the comments. Let us know what you think, what your favourite song of the album is. And if you're at download, let us know what you thought as well. Hit that like and subscribe button. Thanks for watching.